with Raashid Ali, founder and CEO of Jonathan's Kitchen Hyderabad, and he's a well-known personality in food world. I have a few questions for him. Jonathan's Kitchen has been on Gourmet Passport for the last 1 year. So if you could tell us, how has been the experience being on this app?
I think with the current youth being very mobile and internet friendly, it's very important for everyone to be on select apps, one of which is Gourmet Passport. And Gourmet Passport being fairly selective in the restaurants that they choose to partner with has been important for us. The redemption over here through Gourmet Passport has been pretty much right at the top for Hyderabad. The value that is being generated and the footfall that comes actually helps grow awareness of the restaurant, and particularly what is more important is because of the Gourmet Passport offer, people end up trying things looking at the right side of the menu.
Oh, yeah.
So essentially, if you're doing stuff like your New Zealand lamb chops, your lobster tails, etc., start moving because people look at the right side and see value in it and end up trying things which they haven't actually tried or would normally go for should they go for a normal meal.
Yeah.
So I think Gourmet Passport has been a great partner for us in terms of our guests coming and trying menu items which normally they would never go ahead and order.
And I've noticed that you've always been so involved in the new menus, you know, and I'm sure you're somebody who loves good food and you try out each and every dish that is on the menu. So what are your current favorites on the menu?
So my current favorites actually border to the blackened salmon steak or the grilled marl crust. I'm more a fish eater.
Okay.
Some of the steaks over here are really, really nice, whether it's the T-bone or the filet mignon. Barring that, comfort food obviously plays a big role, and you end up trying, you know, going back to your roots and going to food that you recognize, and our menu is structured that way. Jonathan's Kitchen's new menu launch has been one of the biggest things in the city year on year. We change our menu irrespective of what is selling or what is not selling for our patrons to actually come, and there's something fresh for them for a period of 11 months till we again relaunch our menu.
Mm-hmm.
Our chef, corporate chef Vijay Bhaskar Reddy, who happens to be the chef of the year, has played a huge role in developing the menu, and it's basically it's the classics and bring back old stuff like the baked Alaska, etc. So there's something exciting for everyone. Jonathan's Kitchen's menu is designed in a way where you could bring your parents and your children at the same time, and you would have something for everyone to enjoy.
One more thing, the format of Gourmet Passport, you know, many restaurateurs have a resistance to a 1+1 offer. That is what they're scared of. But the fact that we give only 3 coupons per year, how do you think that is a better format as compared to other apps?
It becomes a little exclusive. I have no problem with a 1+1 offer because a tendency of people for 1+1 is to look at the right side of the menu.
Mm-hmm.
We want people to come and try dishes which normally they would not order. So I feel because it's limited, it also gives the restaurant breathing space rather than having an open-ended offer on 1+1. We want people to come and we want people to try things on the menu which normally they would not consider ordering.
Okay. So your buffets have been exceptionally popular in Jonathan's Kitchen right from the beginning, especially your weekend brunch. So how do you decide to go on an app with your buffet in spite of it being a very, very popular product already.
The idea is with today's youth the World Wide Web, everyone wants, everyone is looking out for a deal. And if you're not with the times, someone else will get that business. So the reason our buffets are very popular. You're here today. Yes. You know there's no place to sit, hence we're sitting in the bar.
Oh, yeah. So
we want to be on the apps. The problem sometimes becomes allocation of space and giving the right experience. So we try and limit it to ensure that our guests get a premium dining experience each time they walk in through the doors of Jonathan's Kitchen.
And one is hearing a lot of good things about Jonathan's Kitchen Indore. So how is that different from this?
So Indore, we are part of the Royal Gada Golf Club. So Jonathan's Kitchen has made an entry into Indore. Besides the premium dining space, it's actually we have huge banqueting spaces, so we are hosting a lot of parties and celebrations, etc. Essentially, we're theming stuff in Indore.
So is the menu similar?
The menu is very similar, barring there can't be any beef in Indore. So it's exactly the same menu, a little extra on the Indian side, where we brought in a bit of Rajasthani and Gujarati, given the cultural influence in Indore. We're theming parties, we're making memories there. Recently we did a 25th wedding anniversary, so that was done on a Christian style wedding where the bride walked with the bridesmaids, etc., and a complete white setup. So we're creating memories. Indore is becoming a destination for weddings, celebrations, etc.